Hey guys, Jason here from the One Stop How To Guys, bringing you episode 16 of Practical Drupal Development. In this episode, we're going to be setting up two views here, one to be the sidebar for our About section, and the other that is going to be the entire services section of our website. Now, forgive me if I'm coughing a little bit. I'm feeling a little bit under the weather, but I wanted to get this tutorial out to you so that we can keep moving on with this series. First thing we got to do is set up this sidebar for the About section so that we can actually navigate between all of the different pages within our About section. So we're going to come up to Structure Views, and we're going to add a new view. Now we're actually going to call this view Sidebars, because we might actually use it if we decide later on that, say, we want to actually be able to go to the services content type. We need a way to then navigate between all of those pages as well, and we can reuse this view to create the sidebar for the services section. So for now, we're going to do content of type, and we want about, because we're only doing this to navigate our about pages. We don't want a page, but we do want a block. And an unformatted list of titles is just fine. We're going to get rid of this this items per page, because we want it to actually display all of the titles of our about sections. We don't really want to limit that, or else a page would be missing from our list. We also don't want a title here, because it's kind of unnecessary, unless you want it to say about above the sidebar or something like that, but I really don't see the need for it, because they should know what section of the site they're in by the way that we've structured the URLs and the tab that they clicked on. So we're going to continue and edit. Now, the easiest thing about setting up these type of sidebar views is if you scroll down, you'll see we're actually done. So this is a pretty simple way to set up a sidebar. Now, I do want to show you a couple of the things that are really cool about this sidebar, as opposed to using a menu for our sidebar. If we had used a menu, we're just going to save that and close this down. If we had used just a menu, in order to be able to add items to that list, the user of the site would have to create the piece of content, then navigate over to the menu, list out the links, add a link to the new page, and then it would be available in the sidebar. But it's really easy to forget to do that kind of stuff. So you spend all this time creating the content for a page, and if you forget to add it to the sidebar, well, then nobody's ever going to see it. When you do it through views, however, it will dynamically add that to the sidebar. We're going to go up to Structure Blocks, and we're going to scroll down here to our About sidebar here, and we are going to put this in the sidebar first, and then save this. Now, we don't want this block to appear on every page. If we close that down, you'll see that our sidebar is here, but if we navigate over to the news section, that sidebar is still going to be there, and if we head over to the home page, it's also still going to be here, and that's kind of a problem, because we don't want this sidebar showing up everywhere, much like we didn't want the home page slider showing up everywhere. Now, with the home page slider, we used a trick that that Drupal has built in to place it only on the front page. Well, there's another slightly different trick that we can use to place this on only the about pages, and there's two ways to do that. If you click the little gear icon and do configure block, you'll see down here that we can restrict this to a certain content type. So we could just simply restrict it to the about page, the about pages. Now, you can also come up here to pages and do only on the listed pages and do about /*, and what that's going to tell Drupal is place this block on only those pages that have the URL about / whatever. It doesn't really matter what comes after the about. As long as it starts with about, place this on this sidebar there. So you can use either one of these methods. I'm going to leave them both on. You don't really have to. One or the other would do just fine, but I'm going to leave them both on so that you can see you can either restrict it via the content type or use this about /* to tell it to only be displayed on pages with that URL path. So we're going to save this block information here. And now that Drupal has refreshed, you'll see that when we navigate over to the news section, it's not there anymore, and it's only within our About section. Now, as far as this dynamic view goes and what makes it easier than adding manual links to a sidebar, let's test this whole theory out here. Let's come up to Content, Add Content, and a new About page, and I'm simply just going to title this one About, and I'm going to head over to... Actually, no, I'm not, because we'll probably delete this page out. I'm just going to save this here so that you can see what happens with this sidebar. Now, the About link has automatically been added to the sidebar menu, and we didn't have to remember to put it there. Drupal just did it for us. So views is a great way to kind of dynamically add content to different regions. And from a site building perspective for the end user, the more things that you can automate in Drupal and have happen automatically, the easier it's going to be for the person adding the content on your site. I highly suggest that whenever possible, automate Drupal so things happen automatically, so that users don't get lost, they don't get confused. It's much easier for an end user to come to their site, add a piece of content, and not have to worry about anything else, as opposed to having to add the content, put it in this menu, put it on that menu, make sure it gets onto the homepage. It's just a lot easier this way. And that's just a good site building tip. So I'm just going to come down here and delete this piece of content because we don't really need it unless you want it. But now we have our sidebar set up for the About section. We're going to now set up the entire services section of our website using views. We have the content created. We have the content type created. We put content in it. So let's head up to structure, views, and we're going to add another view here. And this one is going to be called services. And we do want to only show type of service. And we do want to show a page. We're going to need that page title. And its URL is just fine. We're going to select from this display format the grid format, which is going to allow us to specify the number of columns that we want across our page. We do not want teasers or full posts. We just want to select the fields we want to select. We don't need a pager, and we're going to set this to nothing. So let's continue and edit. And now if we scroll down, we can see that we have the title of all three of our services pages. Now we can come up into the grid settings and configure this a little bit so that instead of trying to force four across, maybe we only want to do two. And I'm only doing the grid because I want you to be able to see the different kinds of view displays that we have available here. So let's click Add under the fields, and we are going to type in services. And all we need here is the image and the body. Now, we will not put a label on the body, and we don't really need to do anything else because we're not going to trim this down. We want to be able to see all of the content from this one page. So we'll save that. We'll take the label off of the image. And we'll come back in here and set up a different image style for this specific page a little later, maybe when we get to the theming portion. But for now, we'll just use our basic image here, and we don't want it to link to anything, and we'll apply that. Now, if we scroll down here, we can see that we have exactly what we want happening here. It's just things are not in the right order. If we come up here to the fields and click rearrange, all I'm going to do is drag the image up above the title, because when we theme it, we're going to do something cool with it. Now, the reason that I'm going to wait until we hit the theming portion of this series in order to add the image style to this is because it's going to be determined by, like, when we look at the site, by the time we theme it up enough, how many rows we want across here. And what we're going to do is we're going to make this image the full width of the content here and kind of slimmer. And I don't want to really do that now because I'm not sure exactly what size or how many across we're going to have. So for now, we'll just leave that until we hit the theming portion. Now, we are still capable of getting to this particular page via the title, and that's not something we want either because it's an extra click that we no longer need. So let's click content title, and we will unselect the link this field to the original piece of content, and we'll apply that, and that will pull the link off of that title. And then we will save this to make sure that we don't lose any data. It is good to save your views periodically once you've created them. And we are going to add a menu item here because we need a way to get into our services area of the site. If you remember last time, we didn't add a menu because we said we were going to add it via views. So we want a normal menu entry. The title of this menu entry is going to be services. And the menu that we want to put it in is the main menu. Make sure you change that or you will have a hard time figuring out where exactly your menu item went. So we'll apply that and save this view again. And when we close this down, we should see services tagged on the end here. And when we click that, we find ourselves in the services section of our website. We now are coming near the end of adding content types and setting things up, setting up our views and our sidebars. There's a couple of more things that we do need to do before we close out the building portion of this series, and that is cover web forms. Web forms are vitally important for any website that actually wants to get feedback from their users. So the next episode, what we are going to do is we're going to be covering the web form module, and it's slightly different because it's almost like having a two-part content type where one part of it is a normal, regular old content type like we've seen in the past, and the other part of it is the web form specific portion of it, but it all merges down into one content type, and I want to make sure that we understand how that works, and we'll be using that to build the contact page. The other thing that we need to cover is we need to finish adding some stuff to this homepage, because right now, having a slideshow is great, but it's kind of boring to only have a slideshow here. We want some recent news posts over here, and maybe a featured service right over here, or quick contact. It's just, there's not a whole lot happening here. And then the other big thing that I want to cover is we need to get some social media links down here in the footer so that people have the ability to head over to your Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn account, or even your YouTube account. And we're going to do that by setting up a content type and a view for that as well. And that's going to be a little different. Now, there's a couple of other pieces that we want to add to this site that are not actually going to be content types or anything like that, but things like the wait module so that we can sort our sidebar items and sort our service items and even our homepage slider items. So that's going to be coming. We need to install the color box module so that people can click on our images and have it pop up. So the road ahead looks like this: web forms, finishing up the homepage, adding social media links, and then just some extra feature modules like the wait module and color box. So that's kind of where we're heading. I really do apologize for how somewhat unenthusiastic I am on this tutorial. I'm still not feeling quite 100% yet, but I did want to get this out to you so that you can keep moving forward with this, and hopefully in a day or so, I'll be feeling a little better. I thank you for putting up with my enthusiasticness in this particular episode. But if you like this video, make sure you give it a like, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode of One Stop How To Guys, Practical Drupal Development.